So we've been talking about management and settle sides and the benefit of that heading into a tournament. And then we got to go on to Spain and the worst possible preparation, where they end up sacking their manager 2 days ahead of the World Cup. There's probably never really been a situation like this, but when you think of dressing rooms, and unusual as this is, like, do you look at a dressing room with the experience of Iniesta, of Pique, of Ramos, all of whom have won World Cups and might be playing their last World Cup, and expect that that sort of experience comes to the fore over these couple of days, and that somehow the players take charge and actually everything will be fine? Or is this catastrophic?
It's disaster, right? I mean, the idea of a manager is somebody who leads. And in my experience in football, you could get Iniesta and Ramos and these guys, and they could have totally different ideas on the game. Being great players, you know, great players, but they could have totally different philosophies on the game. And that's why when you get a manager, he overrides their philosophies. Say, okay, I know what you think, but this is what I want you to do. Mm. And they insist on it. Now, what can lead now to it is chaos. Because if Ramos is a strong character and he comes to the fore, Iniesta comes to the fore, and one or two other players come, it's chaos. Because you won't get those four or five players agreeing that this is what we should do. That's how you get the chaos, anarchy in it. So the new man is coming in. We don't know what he's going to be like. There's two things can happen, I think. For example, it could well be that the manager wasn't popular with the players. We don't know that, but it could. I've seen it where the players, people, they wouldn't be popular. They might be glad to get rid of him and show we can do it without him and go with the new guy that's come in. Or else it could be the new guy is not so good, he's a bit weak, and then the players take over. And that's when you get the chaos.
And do we know that after 20 minutes tomorrow night?
Well, it might take a little bit longer than that, Nathan, you know, but it's not, it can't be good, you know, it definitely can't be good. I mean, this fella's been in charge of the team for two years. I think they've been unbeaten for,
20 games.
20 games. So he must be doing something right. That doesn't mean the players like him. They might respect him, and that's what he wants. He's not bothered about whether they like him or they respect him. It's a big blow. I don't understand the president doing what he did, to be quite honest. It seemed to be that he reacted in a personal way, that it was an insult to him that he only learned beforehand that the manager was going to Real Madrid. Mm. Well, I think in this situation, I think you've got to swallow that. Let him do the job. He's going to do the job for Spain anyway. You know, if he goes to Madrid afterwards, it's after the World Cup. And it's not going to do anything. The fella's going to do his... I'd say the players knew he was going to Real Madrid, to be quite honest.
You don't think that he's undermined? Because Luis Rubiales, the president of the Spanish FA, so he only came in May and sort of staked a lot on Lopetegui. He offered him a new 4-year deal straight away.
Yeah.
The first he heard about this was 5 minutes before Real Madrid announced it, where Real Madrid called him.
Yeah.
Lopetegui didn't even have the courtesy to tell him that he was leaving. Does that not show a lack of loyalty that well, simply is unforgivable?
Yeah. I think it was wrong. But in the situation that they're in, I think the president should be doing what's best for the team and for the country. Not to be sacking him out. Okay, so he's going to Madrid afterwards. He was always going to Madrid afterwards. Mm. It doesn't mean he's not going to do the job while he's there. You know, whether the players react to it or not, what he can say is, look, all the players want to do well. They're in the World Cup. They want to do well for their country. So whether the manager is leaving after the World Cup won't affect them, because they're going to do their best, and he's had a good run with them. So I think the president has taken it in a personal way. Not very nice what he did. He should have made him aware of it, or hope that the information wouldn't come out. But I think he should have told the president and keep it quiet between themselves. But I mean, if say we told him four weeks ago he was leaving, would he have sacked him then?
You'd have to say it's very doubtful, because that kind of thing does happen all the time.
So it's an insult. He's taking it in a personal way. This is an insult to me as the president. Well, I think he should put the country before his own feelings in this particular way.